I didn't really start trying to create music until about 8 years ago. It started, I mean, I've always enjoyed music, you know, growing up as a kid, and I've had several different types and styles I like to listen to, but I like rock, pop rock, and alternative. Grew up listening to oldies. I'm a big fan of oldies music. I met Robin at the same studio that I met Charles. It's a small place in Belgium. And it was only about a month ago, and Robin came down, and this guy told me that Robin was gonna be there. So I was like, oh, I gotta go meet him, make a chance to meet this guy. He's a legend, a great drummer and great producer. And so he is one of the coolest people that I've ever met. I mean, he's so down to earth and easy to get along with. He likes to joke a lot. He's just fun to be around.
I'm not here. Is my breath kicking?
Is this one of those pranks?
Is my breath kicking?
No.
All right, cool.
Be good.
Do you have any questions before we start?
Not right now.
I walked up to you. What else could I do? I should buy you a drink and put you on the spot.
Okay, stop. That was brilliant. Really brilliant. I'm going to do it one more time. Okay. Standing by the bar, the word standing.
Yeah.
Let's just do another full one right now. The word standing, you're anticipating a little bit. So okay. I think we should try to like just relax a little bit more into it. All okay. Right. That one's the only word hesitant. The rest of the verse is gorgeous. So one more time.
I saw you from afar, standing by the bar, the cutest girl in here by a long shot. But I do believe I'm ready for last call.
That last part, it sounds good. We don't need to do that.
Yeah, it's kind of...
It's
totally Vegas-y?
Vegas-y.
Well, it's Italy in the
80s. Right.
It's not the 80s in Italy anymore?
No.
It's very dated.
When I was there, I thought it was the 80s still.
Yeah, exactly.
The 90s.
They had poison posters everywhere.
Let's
I went.
Do it. Let's run it. Let's run it four or five times, and we'll do it.
The weight off my shoulder, put it back on the floor, and made me look at it and laugh at it. Hey girl, you make the walls go away, broken down with your power, made me look at all the opportunities.
Of course, when you're doing somebody else's song, you're gonna be nervous. And yeah, I was nervous. I really love that song. I mean, I've liked it since I was growing up. But when Robin told me that he had that song and he'd like to put his own spin on it, you know, make a male version with a U2 type sound.
So I'm thinking more like John Cougars, you know, like. Okay. Straighten it out, on the floor, pedal, you know, footballs, you know what I'm saying?
This is almost a little bit.
So he can do the U2-ish type of guitar, like, you know.
But now I'm nervous and fired up about it, so I'm ready to get it going.
Let's go.
We need a chart.
It's coming, that looks good.
Charles. Charles is my A&R director. We met at a small studio with one of my friends in Belgium.
I don't know why I met him at this moment in Belgium, because I was not supposed to be there. He was not supposed to meet me. I'm doing electronic music as a DJ. And Eric, the CEO of the record label, asked me just if I was interested in getting that job, being an A&R. And I heard his songs and they were like amazing songs, beautiful. And this is how it started, so it's also a new experience to me as it is for him.
It's been great. Charles is fun to work with. He knows a lot about music, of course, because you know, he's a DJ. And the biggest influence on one of my songs is the Beat Is Burning. Hey Robin, what do you think about doubling the chorus, starting at Goodbye? Goodbye, my favorite song.
I got it 178 right now.
Is that the same? Moi j'aimerais un peu tout petit peu plus rapide.
Oh,
excellent. Ça vous dérange? I'd like to try just two beats faster.
It's my happy sad song. You know, it's about telling somebody goodbye.
When you attack the vocals, mm-hmm. My whole thing is for you to just, you know, like to think about, like this song especially, it's like more of a beach thing, mm-hmm. You know, and then I think that it's more of a relaxed thing. So that's, you know, the setting I want you to have in your mind. I think that'll help a lot more, you know?
Yeah.
Cool.
All right, cool. All right. Say, I had a friend one time that had to leave and they had to say goodbye to someone. It's more of a temporary goodbye, you know, you still had hope that you might get a chance to reunite. So it's not completely sad, so
'cause I miss you.
It started out, we were going to record in Belgium. This opportunity with Robin came along, and we decided that, you know, this was the better route to go.
When you come back to Paris, everybody's like, wow, you're going to Capitol to record, and yeah.
Good things, good talent coming here. The best producers, musicians in the world are here. It's a multi-dimensional album. It's about going through tough times. It's about being happy. It's about all your emotions. I know there's something in there that everyone will enjoy. You may go through some hard times, you may have dreams, but never give up on it, because if it can happen to me, it can happen to anybody.
I tended to be kind of cynical. I didn't see angels and miracles. I never did something irrational. Now I feel changes so radical. Just looking at you is so magical. And I don't read your Bible at all, but now I see. Corresponds and mourns. It tells me to stay in and shut the door. To make love while other ones fight their wars. And wake up in each other's arms.